Friends, welcome to edenbrain.com. Today we'll see some of the questions on regular expression. The first question is, length of the string is odd. Now what is odd? Odd means you should have an even length string and then one A or B should be added to it, something like this. So let's have that, one A, right, or B, or A, B, 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 and like that you will have an infinite language again, right? Now how to generate this? First of all, it's better you generate the even length string. I will say that generate even length string first and then you just append, right, one length string. So what I will do is I will simply do A plus B square star. You remember this, right? This way we will be able to generate even length string. And now when you append or concatenate A or B to it, your job is done, right? Similarly, you can say that, or you can have A plus B first and then A plus B square star, right? Now let's see whether only A is generated or not. Only A is generated if star is 0. If star is 0, I will not go inside, and what you will get? You will get epsilon here, and then out of these you can take only A. So this will be equals to A. Similarly, B can be generated. Now 3 A's will be generated or not. If I take star is equals to 1, it means you have to go one time inside. One time inside means it's a square. Means definitely 2 times you have to take any one of the input alphabet. So what I will do is, for that I will take A as the input alphabets. Means star is 1, it means go inside one time, but inside there is a square and that square will give you AA. And now your job is done from here. What you will get after that? You can get A, so which is equals to AA, and that way all the strings of odd length are generated here. Next part is, now each string starts with A. This question, each string starts with A and not having two consecutive B's, right? Now let's see the language. Each string starts with A and not having consecutive B's, and how many? Two consecutive B's should not be there. So means yes, you should be able to generate A, and all A's should be generated like that. An infinite number of A's should be generated, only A's. Is AB generated? Yes, AB can be generated, right? And something like that, right? Now it starts with A, it starts with A, and that's why BA must not be generated. BA should not be generated. So that's why you can understand how to start writing the language. Simply check the minimum possible language. Only A is possible, then all A's are possible. Yes, then let's try to have combinations of A's and B's. If combinations of A's and B's you have to consider, then it should start with A because it's compulsory, and then it can end on B. But A, B, B is also not allowed. So that way you can think these languages are not allowed. So now next language can be allowed is A, B, A, or A, B, A, A. Like this, lot of languages strings are allowed. Again, it's an infinite language. Now how to generate a regular expression on this? See, here compulsory I have to generate A for sure, right? So somehow I have to generate A. Means definitely A plus will be there. You can see here A plus is there. This part is A plus. Why A plus? Because one A is generated, two A's are generated, three A's are generated, and that's why infinite number of A's are generated. Again, you can see this AB is also there. AB, if I have a plus on AB, what you will get? AB will be there. If plus is 1, then AB, AB can be there, right? And then AB, 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 like that you will have an infinite number of A's and B's. Means you want A as well as AB, right? So what I will do is I will have A or AB, and then I will put them into the plus thing, right? Something like this. Now let's see whether I am able to get the required languages. If plus is infinity, I will be able to get all A's of this type, right? Next, if I really want to generate AB only, yes, plus can be 1, and then I will take one of this string, and that is AB here. And then if I want to generate ABA, how I will generate? Plus can be 2 in that case. So plus becomes 2. And now what I will go inside first and I will take AB. So first time I will take AB. I will say first time I take AB, and the second time I will take A, and that way you will be able to generate ABA. What about ABAA? Am I able to generate ABAA? Yes, if plus is equals to 3, I will go 3 times inside. First time I will take AB, yes. then I will take second time A, yes, and then third time also I will take A, and that way these all the valid languages are, valid strings are generated, and that's why I will say this is the final regular expression. Next question is where each string doesn't contain two consecutive A's and two consecutive B's, right? So now consecutive A's and consecutive B's should not be there. It means let's try to have the language first. So drawing a language will make picture much clearer, right? So I can say that epsilon is one of the language possible, right? Next, is only A possible? Yes. Is only B possible? Yes. Now, is AB possible? Yes. Is BA possible? Yes, you can say that, right? So that way you should be able to write all the strings. Like there is again an infinite language, I can say that this is AB, AB, yes, this is quite possible language. So you can see that somewhere AB will be there, a loop of AB will be there, means somewhere in our regular expression AB plus will be there, in our regular expression AB plus will be there. Make sure that A plus will not be there now. A plus will not be there. Why? Because A plus will generate AA and then two consecutive A's will be there. So that way A plus is also not there and B plus is also not there in our regular expression for sure. Now let's see one of the string also. Now if ABB is there, BA must be there. BA, all kind of language strings are possible here. So it means definitely there is a loop of AB. Similarly, there is a loop of BA for sure, right? Now you can see this, when we get a loop of BA, see, it is a loop of BA, you can see this, this is a loop of BA. If I say a valid string A and then it is B, and then if I have a loop of BA, yes, it's quite a valid, you can see this. It means in between of A and B, you can have a loop of AB. So I will draw the regular expression for this now. So what I will say is I must be having A somewhere and then the end will be B, and in between what I will be having, I will be definitely having a loop of BA. So loop of BA means yes, it is a star. Okay, now so this is what is expected. So I hope you understood this. Similarly you can have for BA. So it is for AB. A for AB, the loop of BA will be there. If it is BA, loop of AB will be there. See, if it is BA, the loop of AB will be there in between, right? So first try to understand this part. Loop of BA is there. Now you can see this. AB will be generated if star is 0, right? And now if I really want to generate only epsilon or only A, how will be generating? There is no way possible here because the minimum length string possible is 2, right? Because this star will be 0 and then you will be able to generate A dot epsilon dot B, which is equals to AB. But I don't want that. I want epsilon also. So what I will do is I will have epsilon as or here, and similarly I will have epsilon as or here. Yes, now you can be able to generate epsilon. What I will do, star is 0, then you will be having epsilon here. Star is 0 means again you will get epsilon here, and then again from here you can select epsilon, and that way epsilon will be generated. Now I want to generate only A. How you will generate only A? Star is 0, let's say. Then from this bracket I will take A, then star 0 means epsilon. Again from the last bracket I can take epsilon, and that way I can be able to generate A. And similarly I can be able to generate all the strings, remaining strings. Let's say this string is generated or not. A is the starting, yes. B is the ending, yes. And now the loop of B is there, loop of BA is there, right? Similarly I can say that. Similarly you can do for this, right? So start is B, end is A, and there is a loop of AB, you can say this. There is a loop of AB. So what I will do is I start with B and epsilon and then there is a loop of AB star, and then I will end on A or epsilon. I hope this is the required answer, right? So this is the final regular expression. This is the final regular expression, I can say. Now let's consider the next question. Next question says that contains exactly two A's, and those two A's need not be consecutive. It need not be means it can be consecutive also, right? Need not be means it's not compulsory to be them to be consecutive, but it can be consecutive. Now what I want exactly two A's first. So let's have two A's. So So this way I will have two A's, let's say these are the two A's generated, right? Now this way you will be able to generate two A's. Now what I want strings of E, B's, but, right? So I want all the strings of A's and B's. So it means B, A, B, A. Yes, it's a valid string because there are two A's. Or B, A, A. Yes, it is also valid because there are exactly two A's. So how we will have, I will do one thing. I will say B star simply. So B star A. Again I will say B star A, and again I will say B star A. Why? Because see, now if I want to generate B A B A, what I will do is star will be, let's say 1, so I will take B one time, so this will generate B, and then this will be generated A, always A will be generated, you can see this, and then B star is again, let's say is 1, so again I will generate B, and then again this A is compulsory, and now star I will take at 0, and then you will get epsilon, and that way you will get B A B A, yes. Now will you be able to get B A A? Yes, if star is 1, you will get B as 1s, then all stars I will make 0, and then I will do B A A, yes. So quite valid, and this is the final regular expression which we are looking. The next question says that at most 2 A's are there, means the language can be, at most 2 A's are, means it can be epsilon also, right? Because there are 0 number of A's, it's okay. If only 1 A is allowed, yes, only 1 B is allowed, yes. All B's are allowed, yes. Then are 2 A's are allowed, yes. Is A, B is allowed, yes. And that way you will having an infinite language again. So how to generate it? Now let's see. At most 2 A's means I will do one thing. A plus epsilon, right? And here also I will do A plus epsilon. Now if I really want to take 2 A's, I will do one from here, one from here, something like that. Now I really want B also somewhere. So what I will do is I will put a loop of B. So if you really want to take it, or you can reject it similarly to the previous question. And then it is also a B star. Yes. I can see this. If I really want to generate A, B, A. Yes, what I will do is I will take A from here. Star will be 0. That will give you epsilon. Star will be 0. That will give you epsilon. Then A I will be selecting. Then again star is 1, let's say. Then I will select A from here. And then this star will be 0, and that way you will get ABA. Similarly, you will be able to get epsilon only. If all stars are zeros, then I will take epsilon at the start. Then from these two, I will take epsilon. From again, this will be epsilon. From this also, I will take epsilon. And from the last also, I will take epsilon. And you will finally get epsilon. And if you really want to generate only one A, this will be 0. I will select only one A from here. This will be 0. I will select epsilon from here. This will be 0. And that way only one A is also done, right? So I hope this is the final regular expression which we are looking for. Okay, now the next question, each string contains at least 2 A's. At least 2 A's. Now at least 2 A's means it's again very simple. I will be having at least 2 A's means, let's have the language. 2 A's are there, minimum 2 A's are required, then A B is there, then B A A there, B A, B, A is there, and that way you will be having an infinite language. So how to have at least 2 A's? I will do something like this. So here I will have 1 A and here I will have 1 A. And now in between what I will do is, I will try to generate strings of A's and B's. So it doesn't matter. Previously also I should be able to generate any number of strings, any valid string of A's and B's, and here also I will generate. Now you can see this, if I really want 2 A's only, star, all stars will be 0, and then you will get A. If you really want A A B, then what I will do, this star is 0, this star is 0, then you will get A A, and this star will be 1, and from this 1 star you can select B. If you really want B A A, this star becomes 1, then you will select B, then you will be having A, this star becomes 0, this will be selected, and this star becomes 0. So that way all the strings are accepted. And now let's see the next question. Length of the string is divisible by 3. Divisible by 3 means, a simple language, I will say A A A, A B A, all 3 length string, then all 6 length strings, and that way you will be having an infinite language. So how to have this divisible by 3? It is simple. So I will say that I will be having A plus B cube, that will give me a string which is exactly of 3 length, and then I want a loop of this type. I want a loop on that, right? Because I want 6 length string, 9 length string, and that's why I put a star, and this will be the final regular expression. Where length of the string is at most 3. At most 3 means, it's very simple. At most 3 consists of epsilon. It can consist of A. It can consist of B. It can consist of A. And that way you will get at most 3 means yes, BBB is quite a valid string at last, right? Now how to generate epsilon? I will do something like this, epsilon or A or B. Yes, this will generate epsilon or A or B, right? And similarly, I might be required 2 A's. So what I will do, again, I will do something like this. And you might require 3 A's, then you require something like this again. So that is equivalence to, that is equivalence to A plus B with epsilon Q, right? So I hope you understood this. Now you can see this, if I really want to generate epsilon only, what I will do, I will select epsilon from all these three and then you will be able to generate only epsilon. If you really want to select only A, then I will select epsilon, epsilon here and then I will select A here. If you really want to do B, I will select B here and then I will select epsilon, epsilon here. That way you will be able to generate all the strings of at most three lengths, right? So this will be the final regular expression for that. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, do like this video. If you have any questions, please put it into the comment section. I will definitely get back to you. Thank you.